Breathe down, go.
Go, down. Down.
Tactical falls. We're going to start with the basic back falls. Before you send any of your recruits or officers out to do any takedowns, you need help to let them figure out how to fall naturally. All right, falling first. If you're police or corrections, depending on if you have a gun or you don't have a gun, we're going to start with your mock weapon out. A little bit about mock weapons. You should shave them down a little bit so that when you wrestle around with them, there's no sharp pieces on it that can cut anyone. We're going to start from the ground, work our way up to standing, and that way the officers get a little bit more comfort with the positions of the fall, and we can work all the way up to a dynamic fall with a bad guy. So let's start off first on the ground. Okay, start with the recruiter officer on the ground, seated. Have them take their mock weapon out. You're going to kind of hold it between their knees, and you're just going to have them roll back. When they roll back, they want to do two things. One, tuck their chin in, use the curvature of the back to roll, and use your feet as counterbalance. So as they roll back, they can keep the gun on target and come back up to either a seated position or a defensive position on the ground. All right, so another angle, sideways here, keeping the hands here, roll back, come back up to a neutral position, or stay down to offensive position or defensive. Okay, now we'll take the student up to a standing position, but we'll have them go to a squatting position, then roll back and take their fall. So from the front view here, have them squat, gun down, roll, and fall. Okay, from the side view, squat, fall. Okay, now we're going to put it in motion to where we're going to back up for a partner and we'll sit and squat as soon as we make contact with the person. Okay, the one thing you don't want to do when you feel that you're going to fall is reach back with your hands. If your hands fall back and your hips go forward, that's where you're going to do damage on your wrists. Kind of like rollerblading. When you fall, that's what's going to hurt. So, start with your gun out, keep your hands on the weapon, back up, make contact, sit. Roll back. If it's a cover position, you're still firefighting, get behind the cover, tell them neutralized, get up, move offline. Okay, from a front view, I'm backing up, bad guy's coming towards me, I trip on the curb, I take my fall, still able to engage the suspect here, or if I'm shooting, move behind the cover. See, there, tell us neutralized. For officer survival, what you want to work up to is that you're able to fall and draw your weapon at the same time to engage a suspect that's either attacking you, knife, hands, or you need to go to lethal force and you need to get your gun out, not worrying about the fall, but getting your gun out. So the next drill is, start with your hands up, interview position. You'll walk backwards. When you feel contact and feel yourself going down, start to draw your weapon and get it out of the holster. Okay, same thing. Either engaging or moving where the suspect's moving before you get up. All right, falling backwards while drawing, moving backwards, get contact, hand on the gun, draw, pick up your thread, be able to move. Meet up for defense or to move side to side. We're going to continue shooting, moving away. Front falls. If you're falling to the front, you want to make sure that, especially if you have your weapon in your hand, that you're not discharging it or that you're not going to shoot yourself in the head. If you're starting to fall forward, you want to create a triangle with your arms, landing on your from your elbows to your fingertips, dispersing it along a bigger area than just your wrist itself. So as you're falling, you want to bend your hips. We'll start from right here. Turn the gun to the side. Turn your head to the side. So that you don't impact your nose on the weapon. Sideways and land.
And now we go up to our feet. If you're going to the ground, you want to get as much of your body to the ground as soon as possible. So as you're falling, go ahead and go to your knees. Dive into the fall. Support it on your forearms, elbows to fingertips. The technique can also be used to get to the ground quickly. If you're moving somewhere, you need to drop down for low cover and to get on shooting down range. So from here, basically, I'm just dropping straight to the ground, being on target. Most officers that are attacked, statistically, end up falling on their sides. So if we're going to fall on our side, we want to be able to disperse the energy throughout our entire body, use our legs kind of as a counterbalance, and I still have some mobility with them, but I also have my gun on target. So this is the end position you'd like to end up in, all right, with your gun obviously towards the threat. In the next drill, we'll start from the seated position and give you a chance to feel moving the weapon across your body, moving your foot across, going to your shoulder and rolling up. So we'll start here, we'll move, roll up to one side, come back to neutral, use the other arm, come across, end up on the other side. Okay, now we'll take it standing, same thing. Your gun's drawn, low ready, sweep your feet, and one foot to the left, and your gun will come across the ground and you'll sit to the hip and roll up. So it'll look like this. Bring your gun out, sweep across, gun on target. Okay, other direction, gun stays neutral, hand comes across, sit, and you're on target again.